Okay. Chances are you're indoors for quite a long time. Hopefully you're not bored. Probably not. You have a lot of things to do. Maybe you'll be binge watching. You'll probably be reading a lot. Hopefully there's a lot of things you can do offline, but online, I thought I'd take you on a tour of my favorite website of all. This is Zooniverse.org, and I'm just going to take a tour of some of the projects. Here's Galaxy Zoo. I'll show you that one. Okay, so they're going to show me some galaxies, and I need to categorize the galaxy. Okay, so wow, that's pretty amazing. You get some amazing images here in Zooniverse. So that, I believe, is a features or a disc, I would say. Okay, and then to next. No, it's not a John. That's something else. Okay, next. I would say it doesn't have a bar. I always sort of struggle with this, but no bar, I'd say. Next. Yes, it has two spiral arms, I would say. So I type yes. I would say that's loose. You think? I don't think it's medium, I think it's loose. So I'm putting loose. Okay, two spiral arms there. Large sort of center, I would say. Maybe it's dominant. I would say large. And the thing about Zooniverse is, even if you're wrong, you know, there'll be more than one person probably looking at this image and categorizing it. So, would I say that that's merging those two galaxies? I would say so. So I'm going to take merging. Anything else? No ring, there's an arc. I don't think so, so nothing unusual. Type. And that's it done. Now it's moved on to the next galaxy. And once you get the hang of it, you can just speed through it, and you get some really wonderful images. You have the option of favoriting an image. Okay, on to another project. And there's a whole host of projects, and they're always adding more projects. Right now, I think they've got maybe 50 or so projects on the go. So here's the one that I have contributed the most to. This is Chicago Wildlife Watch. Help us understand how animals from coyotes to chipmunks share this great city with us. And it's a video capture around various areas of Chicago, Ooh, there's a deer. Great shot. So type in deer from all the options I have here. How many deer? One. There's no young present, so I don't click on yes. It's easy as that. And then I'm done. Let's see. Wow, for that one. Hey. Okay, and I go on to the next photo. And there's a grey squirrel. Bit of a blur. Must be moving. So, grey squirrel. Just one. Next. And there you go. And you also have the option of talk, which is you can leave a little comment like I'm not too sure, or hard to tell, or nice sort of flower sort of in a corner if you see one. Any sort of like comment like that, and there's a wee grey squirrel sort of hidden away. Grey squirrel. And it's as easy as that, and you'll be up to like 100 photos in a very, very short time. You'll just be doing bit after bit and have a grey squirrel. Okay, I'm going to go on to another project. There's so many. And all sorts of things. Here's a Bash the Bug, which is sort of a medical thing. I think they've all been done already, so it's... yeah, it says already seen there. In the corner, what you do is there's no growth in number two, so I'm just using this as an example. No growth from I would say number two onward, so highlight two and then go on to done, and that's it. You're on to the next one. So it's sort of, it's just really easy stuff, and it really does take your mind off things. You get immersed in it very, very easily. What other projects do we have? Here's a transcribing project. Measuring the Anzacs help us tell the stories of all New Zealand servicemen and women from World War One. And sometimes you will get a little tutorial that comes up and it'll tell you what to do, and you know, if the help button is there if you need any issues with anything. Okay, so you have this sheet here, surname, what was it? Not too sure. And I'll put it in here. John. Okay, I'm gonna move on to another project. That might be, the transcribing ones can be a little bit lengthy, but we're still, once you get the hang of it, you'll breeze right through. What else do we have? quite a few nature projects we have. Some history. splotch. Slightly different from the other sort of nature ones I showed you. You'll have a image here of a cliff face of an island, and you'll highlight whatever birds are seen in that area. I don't see any. I see a kitty right there. Hey, up there. And you just click on it to highlight. Click on that highlight. And I think that's the only one I see. So you've also got guillemots, kittiwee chicks, and guillemot chicks. You need to zoom in because they're quite hard to see sometimes. Okay, so just the one I see. The talk option there, or just a comment section. So here we've got a lot more kitty wakes up there. So again, it can be quite lengthy, but once you get the hang of it, click 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 click, you know, those birds. Once you get the hang of it, you really can breeze through. They're often changing these projects all the time, so some will be finished or near finishing, and others on page one, those will just have started. But there's a lot for you to do, a lot to find out, some amazing and interesting stuff to keep you occupied. So hopefully you're doing well. Thanks for watching. Bye.